Hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is the number one place for spiritual people who are interested in dreams and the dream world, and also connecting with spirit to receive insights, guidance, and messages around how they can overcome challenges in their daily life. In this video, I am sharing dream oracle messages for the full moon in Gemini. These are channeled messages that I receive from spirit while asleep in the dream world. These dream oracle messages will help raise your consciousness, live more aligned with your higher self, and allow you to live more in harmony as you move through the different phases and stages of your life. If you are interested in videos around dreams, all things dreams, and getting messages from spirit, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss out. So how this works is I'm going to share with you the dream, and it's gonna sound, let's be honest, super freaking weird. And then I'm gonna share the messages. And now when I say the dream is gonna sound really weird, it's because I can only share part of the experience that I experience while in the dream world. I can just share the dream itself. It's really hard to explain all the senses that are happening while I'm connecting with spirit in the dream world. So I'm just gonna sound like a crazy person and we're just gonna go with that. So anyways, the dream. Okay, so I was in what sort of felt like New York City and I was going to see my business coach. And during my session with the business coach, I had two computers. I had a MacBook and I'm a Mac person. I love Mac. So for me, that was like everything was working smoothly when I was typing on the Mac and doing all the work on the MacBook. And then for some reason, I pulled out this other old clunky PC that was like probably the oldest computer, first laptop computer ever made. It was also really tiny and I couldn't really see it and it wouldn't stay open and I couldn't really type very well on it. And I remember thinking in the dream, I should probably use the new MacBook. Why am I using this clunky PC? But anyways, that's what I did. My session with my coach wrapped and I left, and as I was leaving to head home, I was walking down this path and I ran into this group of young gentlemen, and these young gentlemen didn't look like young gentlemen how we might describe young gentlemen. They looked like they were kind of like street bums. They looked a little disheveled, and there was a group of them, and I was a single woman walking on my own. There was nobody else around, and in my dream, I was like, oh my gosh, I hope these guys don't attack me. I hope they don't bother me. Like, I just hope to be invisible and just walk by. And then the one in the middle, he stopped and he was like, he just started talking about how he like hates how people perceive him this way and how he dresses is, he was like, I'm an artist and this is just my expression of who I am. And he's like, I'm a really nice person. And we had this nice, beautiful conversation. And I was like, oh, this is really interesting. And I was like, cool, like, thanks for explaining that. That's awesome. I'm glad I got to know you and like, have a good day. And they went on their way and I went on my way. And as I was walking home, I kind of walked through this, like, it was like these archways, but it was like a mall, a shopping center mall, and I was walking through. And then I was walking along and I noticed that there was this woman who was Brené Brown. And I don't know if you know who Brené Brown is, but I will explain that when I go through the messages. But if you do, I ran into Brené Brown and I was like, oh my gosh, Brené, I love you. I love your work. We have to take a selfie. And so I got out my phone, my iPhone, and I was like trying to take a selfie, and then it ended up being this really weird boomerang. And I was like messing with my phone, trying to take this selfie. And long story short, I ended up snapping one, but I was just like, I was disappointed with the result of the picture. I thanked her, carried on down the mall, and then I came upon this performance that was happening. It was like a theater performance happening in the mall, and there was all these actors, and I was thinking in the mall, I was like, I wonder if these performers are Broadway performers, and this is what they're doing as like a side hustle, because their main hustle is to be a very successful, well-known Broadway performer, and they're just doing this to like get by to support them, but they're still doing things that they're passionate about, because you could feel this energy and there was a sense of freedom from these performers. And I was like, wow, that is so cool. And then I carried on, and by now another friend of mine had joined me, and I was making my way to a train station, and I was trying to figure out the tickets, and I didn't have the right ticket and the machines weren't working. And then I was like, oh man, I really hope there's somebody here who can help me, because the ticket that the machine was trying to sell me was like 100 US dollars to go like one way for two people, which is ridiculous. So I knew it was incorrect. And anyways, I like turned around and there was this lovely man who worked there and I was like, could you please help me? And he helped me and I said where I needed to go. And he's like, oh, this is the platform, the train platform you need to go to. He pointed me in the right direction and I was like, awesome, this is great. And then essentially I woke up. So what the heck does this all mean? If you are curious, please give the video a thumbs up now and I can dive into what the meanings and messages were in this dream. Okay, so the first part that we're gonna dive into is the computers that I was using when I was having my session with my business coach. And it's really all about what beliefs or patterns or programmings or things in our life, systems that we're using in our life that don't support what we need to do. What things are we holding on to because we're used to old comforts, but really they're not supporting us. So it was like, I could have used the MacBook that worked perfectly and was fast and efficient. But in the dream, I chose to use this clunky old computer that made my life more difficult and was harder, didn't function properly. So it's like, what can you let go of in your life that doesn't support you in your goals, in moving forward, in accomplishing what it is that you want to accomplish? So it's an invitation to really take a look at your life and see, are there beliefs and patternings that don't support where you want to go? Are there systems that don't support what you want to accomplish? And maybe there's just like actual things that just don't work and you need to purge and get rid of these things so you can allow what is new and what is supportive to move in and come into your life. The next message was around the young men that I run into, and it's all around judgments. You know, we are often too quick and judge a book by its cover, and we don't take the time to listen and connect and get to know other people before we make these snap judgments. You know, in the dream, I judged this person and his friends, thinking that they were bad, thinking that they were going to attack me, when really they are just a beautiful expression of who they are. And when I stopped in the dream and listened to them and got to know who they were, what they were about, what they represented, it was actually quite beautiful. So it's an invitation to stop the judgment and step into more compassion and your heart space and connect with others from a beautiful heart space and curiosity and getting to know who they truly are before we make these snap judgments. The next message was Brené Brown. So if you don't know who Brené Brown, she is like the queen of vulnerability. She does this amazing, or did this amazing TED Talk on vulnerability and how vulnerability makes us beautiful. And so in the dream, this was so perfectly represented by my desire in the dream to take this perfect selfie with her. And none of the selfies were perfect. They were not quote unquote Instagram worthy. They wouldn't be or look nice in like this perfect Instagram feed. And I know there's so many of us, myself included, who want to have and present ourselves to the world in this perfect image. And in truth, it's our messiness that makes us beautiful. It's the weird quirkiness that makes us unique and different. And it's also like how I feel about sharing these dream messages sometimes. You know, like I just shared this dream. At the beginning, I was telling you how I'm sure I'm gonna sound crazy, and it's because I'm insecure about it. And I just need to step into this vulnerability that I feel when I do these videos and say, screw it, I'm showing up this way. This is my unique way of showing up in the world. Some people are gonna love it, some people are gonna hate it, some people are gonna think I'm crazy, and who cares? This is me, this is how I'm gonna show up. And so this is an invitation for you to do the same. The next message was when I saw the performers in the mall, and it is really about passion and stepping into what it is that you're passionate about and doing what you're passionate about, because when you do, you have this like freedom. When you are living a life of passion, you are free. You have this energy that runs through you and you can show up and be in this world in a much more joyful way, in a much more free way. And that energy, when you emanate that energy and interact with others emanating that energy, you are contributing so much to this world that you don't even know. And so it's really about stepping into what it is you're passionate about and allowing that to expand. So maybe you have a side hustle and you're like, I don't know how I can make this a full-time thing. Just keep doing it and keep finding ways to be in that energy of what you're passionate about more and more in your daily life, and it will grow. It's not gonna grow overnight, but it will grow and you will shift and it will just automatically shift without you thinking about it. But it does require you consciously making that decision to step into your passion and to step into that joy on a much more regular and consistent basis through your daily life. Now, the next message at the train station for me, this one is like an obvious one. When we're on our path, you might be thinking, you know, I'm talking about how do you step into your passion more and wondering that for yourself. And it's really that guidance is always going to be there for you. The lovely man at the train station who helped me with my ticket and pointed me in the right direction just came out of nowhere. When I first entered that train station, I was by myself with my friend. There wasn't anybody to help. And help always appears when you need it, and spirit is always there to guide you, whether that's the form of another person helping you in your life, or whether it's spirit and spirit moving things in the world that we can't see and shifting energies around us to support us, to help us move into and walk the path that we are meant to our highest purpose and what it is that we desire in life. So those are the messages. I hope you've enjoyed them. I would love for you to comment below and let me know what message resonated the most with you. Also, these are general messages. Now, if you are new to me, I am a dream oracle. That means I do have this very unique and odd gift where I can go into the dream world, and while I'm asleep, I connect with spirit and receive messages. So I can actually do this on a one-on-one basis with clients. And what is really unique about this type of dream oracle reading is what I call it, I can actually go into deep psyche and understand what your deep blocks and barriers are in your subconscious that you might not even be aware of. So if you have a challenge in your life or something that you want to manifest, but you have blocks and barriers and you don't know what they are, then feel free to reach out to me. You can book Dream Oracle readings with me. My website is in the description below, so feel free to connect with me anytime. Also, I would love for you to connect with me on Instagram. I share Dream Oracle messages there as they come up as well. So make sure you follow me at Dream Oracle Holly. And now, have you ever had a dream where your teeth fall out? I'm sure you have, because pretty much everybody has. And if you have and you're curious to know what that dream is all about, then make sure you come back next week, because I'm going to dive into what those dreams are all about. What does it mean when your teeth fall out in your dreams? So make sure you subscribe and you hit the bell and you don't miss that video. If you're interested in starting to understand and decipher your own dreams, I've created these other two videos. Hopefully they have popped up here. If they haven't popped up here, then I will put them in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. I post videos every Tuesday. I will see you next week.